I'm here at Goldie's Barbecue, recently voted number one best barbecue in all of Texas, and I think I came late. It's a Friday, so I didn't think it'll be this many people here, but this is about right now 30 minutes after they open, and a line is almost outside of this parking lot. I'm hoping nothing will be sold out by the time I get there.
Wait, you got simples or the brisket?
Yeah, we got some burn-in.
Oh, amazing. No way, you're awesome. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. We need like a pound of that. 2 pounds? Oh, that's good.
Is that the best burn-ins you had in Texas?
Yeah, I like how they're not super sweet.
They're not sweet, and it's so smoky, and so... Whoa, we need more of that. If we don't get it, you know, if it's sold out by the time we get there, at least we tried it.
Why are they starting at the end? Is it like just in case you don't get it?
Yeah, just in case we don't get any. Which is a good move, which I'm really thankful for, but... Oh, we need more of that. Definitely appreciate them bringing out barbecue for people at the end of the line to try in case they're sold out. And also, look at this. They give you free drinks here. So you got water, you got beer. Take water. Oof. Yeah, don't make the same mistake I did.
Another piece of the burnt ends. Oh, look how beautiful it is. Just in case I don't get this in the front, let me give you guys a close-up look at this.
Look at this dripping piece of meat. Perfect crust, beautiful layer of fat. Oh. Slightly sweet, super smoky. That one was better than the last piece I had. Oh, that was so good. It was like a slurp-worthy burn-in. Not so much juice in there. I'm praying to the barbecue guys right now that get up there, still a bunch of that stuff left.
I'm with Chuck right here. What's the one thing you gotta try here?
Brisket
for sure.
I mean, we just spend so much time and care on it. And well, everyone knows that everything else is like equally as good. I start the brisket cook in the morning and I just like make sure every little detail is perfect, from the seasoning to like how I put them on the smoker and the fires and the smoke. It's all super important. And I think it's just us really, really caring about every single little detail.
Well, I had a little taste while I was waiting in line, so I'm excited for this. And then you just told me there is enough for
waiting in line.
I'm good, I'm good. Thank you so much.
Yeah,
thank you. Finally at the door.
Excited.
Yes, sir.
I don't know, it's just like getting to the front of a barbecue line. It's more exciting than, you know, waiting for like 2 hours and get on Magic Mountain at Disney.
It truly is.
How's it going, y'all?
Hey, how are you doing?
Where are y'all coming from?
Coming from St. Louis.
Oh, cool. I've never been to St. Louis. We all did this right here today.
Can we do a pound of brisket?
A pound of brisket?
Fatty as possible. And okay. If you have any burn-ins, that'd be amazing too.
Perfect. What about sausage for y'all today?
Yeah, let's do a jalapeno. And then some beef rib if you can.
Yeah, one beef rib.
And can we do some ribs?
Some pork ribs. How many pork ribs are y'all thinking?
What do you think? Like a couple?
2 pork ribs, 1 sausage link, 1 beef rib.
Yeah. Oh, there we go.
Have y'all been here before?
Have not.
Well, thank y'all so much for coming out.
Oh, thank you. Thank you guys for doing what you do. You know me? Yeah, hey. Hey, thanks. You do? All right, well, thank you. Appreciate that.
And you said no turkey?
No turkey.
No turkey.
I don't do turkey until Thanksgiving.
Okay, ours is pretty good.
Yeah?
I think so.
I mean, I'll take a slice.
One slice off.
Yeah.
1.4 beef ribs.
1.4 beef ribs.
1.4 beef ribs.
What is it? Count down?
Awesome.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Sure.
Homemade bread?
Yes,
you guys homemaker bread?
Yeah, we make it in-house, the dough. We bake it in-house as well, too.
You guys are a bunch of overachievers.
Yeah,
you really are. It's about 10 pounds of food right here. I got pretty much everything on the menu. To say I'm excited would be such an understatement. Let's eat barbecue. Woo! This is a lot of barbecue. Such an overwhelming feeling getting a plate of, every time, I don't care how many times I've done this, every time I'm sitting in Texas and got a tray of barbecue in front of me, butterflies. Seriously, let's just start with this. Look at this crusted giant piece of beef rib. The butterfly sensation intensifies. We're in the presence of a giant beef rib. Oh, what the actual heck, wow. First of all, I don't know if you can tell, this is just dripping juice. This beef rib, what sets it apart is that it's got an amazing crust on the outside. What's up, buddy?
Hey, Mikey, how are you?
Look who showed up, look who showed up. This is really funny. Yeah, Harry.
Hi, guys.
This guy cooked a full-on barbecue feast for me when I visited your house in Diamond Bar. Yeah. What are you doing here?
These are my friends. I came by to hang out with them and say hello and see how they produce their magic that won first place in the Texas Monthly.
All right, I gotta pick your brain. Sit down for a second.
Okay, all right.
Well, let me ask you, there's a crust on this beef rib.
Yes.
This is something kind of new. Like, it's there's an obvious crust. Yes. This is not, I mean, I don't think I've had a beef rib that's as crusty as this. Yes.
So it's been cooked for about 5-6 hours in the pit, with nothing except seasoning and not wrapped in any foil. Look at that. Look at the juice. Look at the tenderness. Mm-hmm. So this is pretty incredible. So it's crunchy. Tasty, beefy, heaven. That's the only description. That look on Mikey's face is real because if you've never been to Fort Worth, Texas, you guys need to try out Goldie's Barbecue. These guys are amazing, amazing pitmasters. And they are the new upstarts that is causing the evolution of the revolution in barbecue. So a lot of
they've
the
only
traditional,
been doing this for like about a year.
A year, but the thing is they all have pedigree. So every single one of them are in their 20s. And they have all cooked in all of the top barbecue restaurants
I heard about that, yeah.
And what is interesting is that they've known each other sometimes up to back to kindergarten.
Yeah.
They decided that this would be something they would do, and they would only do it Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and no other days because they felt that that is the only way to focus their efforts to produce a world-class product. And, you know, it shows. When you eat the food, you know a lot of love went into the food.
It's transporting you to somewhere special because, I mean, just the beef rib alone, that crust is something I never tasted before. And it's like just the smoky hit. And look, it's still dripping like it just got out of the shower.
Yes.
It's still dripping. Yeah, this place, I didn't try, what did you call this?
This is the pork hash.
Pork hash.
And it's really amazing that they serve this because it really reminds me of Filipino pork adobo.
That's one of the best sides I've ever had in my life. Not even joking, a little bit. That's so amazing.
They should serve it as a main course, not a side.
Oh no, that's what I was gonna say. This I would get as a, like, I would buy this by the pound. This is one of the best sides, if not the best side at a barbecue place. First of all, what you said is perfect. It's a little sour vinegary. Mm-hmm. The pork melts in your mouth. The rice is great too. Wow, this is good.
It's a really unusual dish to have in a barbecue restaurant, but really, really, it shows the care and dedication and focus of all these individuals.
Well, what have you been up to these days, Harry?
We've been traveling, and I'm going to be retiring from my day job in December.
Okay.
And next year in 2022, I'm going to follow Mikey's example and travel around the world and eat great food.
You should have done that a long time ago. I mean, you're such a talented barbecue pit master, and like, you do such great work. Have you been eating barbecue every day?
Look at you. I've been trying my very best to stay healthy.
I remember when you cooked a feast. Did you eat a lot of it? I don't think you ate that much.
I know you ate like 5 pounds of it. This guy can really pack it away. So pretty amazing. Mikey is definitely a beast.
I didn't expect to see you here, but good seeing you. I'll put Harry's information down below for you guys if you want to give him a follow. But good luck on your new venture.
Okay.
I'm sure it'll be amazing. Right. And keep me informed because I want to stop by for more barbecue.
We'll do that.
It's pretty cool when you come to an amazing barbecue spot like this and you see a legendary pitmaster just walk by. Anyway, back to the food. This is why I've been kind of leaving out this crusty piece of pork rib. Zero exaggeration, my mouth just filled up with juice. I need to chase that with something. Oh, coleslaw, perfect. I feel like I needed something to kind of balance that out, cleanse the palate a little bit. Couple bites of this coleslaw, which is so vinegary and delicious. Exactly what the pitmaster ordered. I'm not a beans person.
These barbecue beans are too good. Not a single bad bite so far. Not a single unexceptional bite so far. That brisket. That is a life-changing brisket. When you bite into this, it's like the barbecue gods came and just gently kissed you on the lips. So smoky and tender. And I'm glad they gave me a little preview while I was waiting in line, so I kind of could prepare myself for the magnificence of, you know, a lot of it. It's like watching a great movie trailer, expecting to see a fantastic movie. And your expectations are 100% met and then some. Pork ribs. Whoa. This is so, I want to say this. A lot of the things I've tried so far is really different than the other Texas barbecue places I've been to. First of all, ribs are fantastically juicy. Like every bite I'm taking, more juice is flowing out of me. Secondly, the flavor of these pork ribs is one of the best I've ever had. A touch of honey in these ribs, along with the savory, smoky flavor, levels these all the way up to pork barbecue heaven. Oh my God. Oh, that's good. All right, I tried all the sides. Not a single one that's not mind-blowing. Favorite, pork hash. Oh, love the grits so much. Jalapeno sausage. Oh. Oh, that's a nice snap. That is a nice snap. If this sausage played in the NFL, every single time the quarterback would be like, that's a nice snap. That's a really nice snap. That's a perfect snap. This is unbelievable. Wow. Oh, this barbecue place is off the hook. This is, I think, by far, I mean, I know it's good and it's rated number one. Couple bites in, you're like, okay, I get it. It's different, it's better. I get why this is number one. The sausage, again, beautiful casing, cheddar cheese inside. Jalapenos provide such a nice bite. There's amazing peppery flavor and oh, so much smokiness. How good is the pork ribs?
Super amazing.
Is that the best pork rib we've had in Texas?
I think so. You didn't even try the sauce yet.
I gotta try the sauce?
Yeah, it's really good.
All right, I gotta try the sauce. What's the sauce good on?
Everything.
Everything?
Drink it.
Drink it? That good?
I used it all.
You ate all that sauce on like one rib? All right, I'm gonna dunk some brisket into it. Oh yeah. Oh, that sauce is off the hook. This is sausage even better than it is, and already spectacular. I'm gonna try a piece of their homemade bread. This is so good. What did Harry say it tastes like? The
Hawaiian buns?
Yeah, I agree. This is so good. I want more of this. I'll dip it in the sauce. Wow. So soft with a touch of sweetness. Wow. If you just give me the sauce and the bread, I'm happy. I think it was the first time I finished a piece of bread in a barbecue joint. Totally forgot about the smoked turkey. I feel like I let the smoked turkey sit here a little longer than I should have. How is this so tender? Tell me that's not the best smoked turkey we've had.
We should get our turkey from here.
For Thanksgiving? Wow, that's good smoked turkey. I wasn't gonna get this. I was in there. They were like, you want a smoked turkey? I'm like, nah, I only eat turkey once during Thanksgiving every year. Get the sliced turkey here. Again, not a single bite that wasn't completely exceptional. You know, sometimes you go to barbecue places, you'll like the beef rib, but maybe you won't like the brisket. Maybe you'll like the brisket. Maybe you won't like the pork rib. Here, I love all the meats, including the turkey. I love every single of the sides. The sauce is mind-blowing. Even the bread is amazing. Yeah, there's something special about this place. Now, only thing to do, put it all together. Piece of bread, a little fatty brisket, some of the smoked turkey, a little crust from the beef rib, coleslaw, and drizzle on the sauce. I don't want this barbecue sandwich to end ever. Melty fat from the brisket, crunch from the coleslaw, fantastic smoky flavor from the turkey. I can't believe I've been complimenting turkey so much, but it is indeed that delicious. Oh, forget it, I just need to dunk it in the sauce. So if you're wondering if this place
lives up to the hype. I'm telling you, it exceeds it. If you're wondering if this place is deserving of the title Best Barbecue in Texas, of all the places I've been to, this is the best, no comparison. There's something just extraordinarily special about every single thing they make here. So if you're wondering if you should be coming here getting some of this barbecue for yourself, I say if you're in Dallas and it's Friday, Saturday, or Sunday, I don't know why you haven't left your house yet, but 100% put this barbecue place on your bucket list. Not just your barbecue bucket list, your entire food bucket list, this should be on it. Come here, say hi. Okay. Newpont, yes, Newpont, you're one of the founders of this place.
Yes, sir.
Dude, this, I just got done talking. Mm-hmm. I said this should be like on everyone's bucket list.
Awesome.
Like, there's something just special about the way you guys make your barbecue. Mm-hmm. First of all, the pork ribs.
Yeah.
Is that honey?
No, it's just sugar. Yeah, just white sugar in there.
Just white sugar in there.
Yeah.
Wow. That makes such a difference.
Yeah.
That little bit of sweetness.
Mm-hmm. And it's a light glaze too. We don't like the thick ones. So in the light glaze, it gives it like a nice, it gives the pork ribs a more porky flavor.
Amazing.
And it's still sweet a little bit.
And I love how you brought a little Asian infusion into the food.
Yeah.
That mash, the hash.
Oh, the hash is actually more of a Carolina.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's a Carolina thing. Yeah. It's kind of, it has like Asian essence to it.
I love it.
Yeah, it's super good.
Like Harry was saying, that tastes like an adobo. It does.
Yeah.
It's kind of right. It's so tender.
So I'm Laotian. So we do like Lao sausage on every Saturday.
We have that one day.
Yeah, just one day. Because we're trying to do it every service, but we make, for one day, we make about 150 links.
What does that go? Will that sell out in like half an hour?
That one actually lasts throughout the day.
Really?
But it comes with sticky rice and jill sauce.
I heard about that. I wish I could have some of that. Yeah. Sauce is amazing.
Thank you.
So good. What else? Turkey. I never eat turkey.
Turkey's the one that gets stuffed.
Wow.
It's super juicy. It's super flavorful. And that's when people ask me what's my favorite thing here, I pretty much tell them it's the turkey.
Oh, the turkey is exceptional. Also the bread.
Yeah.
I never made a sandwich in a barbecue place before because I usually, I'm like, bread, well, I don't need this. I'm just get the meat.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm like, yeah, I need to make a sandwich with that bread.
Yeah.
It's so good.
Yeah. Thank you.
Good job, man. You guys are doing great stuff.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. So we opened up like almost two years ago, and it was like right before the pandemic happened. And we just been, you know, cruising, and we got lucky we survived the pandemic, and I mean, it's still going on, but we're things are looking up for us, so.
Oh, yeah. Only good things in your future, for sure.
I hope so.
All right, after the barbecue, not really sure what happened. I did have a thought, maybe I'll just lay down for like 10 minutes, and then it's 7:30 at night now. At this cool ramen place called Nikujin, where, look at this. It's an appetizer, noodles, steak, drinks, dessert. That sounds good to me. Oh, the food has arrived. Spicy pork-based ramen with spicy shrimp. Four words: rich, spicy, creamy, awesome. It honestly doesn't look like that spicy because I was kind of expecting a spicy ramen to be pretty red. This is spicy. Noodles are very good. Texture is nice. Make sure to eat it with some of the broth. This is good. I mean, I'm kind of weird after a day of eating like tons of fatty meat. I just crave noodles in a rich, porky broth. This is the steak part. So the steak is already, looks like medium rare. And then they give you this little grill, stone grill, to cook it even more. This is ridiculous. Oh, crunchy outer shell. Deliciously juicy, tender steak. Steak and this creamy sauce. Oh, this is so good. First of all, this is a lot of fun grilling it on the stone, but this is actually supremely delicious. The sauce is delicious. The meat is tender and juicy. Outside crunchy and nice. I mean, I think I might have just gonna cook this just a little bit on each side.
Bite of steak. Slurp of noodles. I don't think I've ever had a steak and ramen combination before. Unless you're talking about the Japakuri. Like, I never had like a soupy ramen in a set of steak before. Such a good compliment to each other. Or just grill a steak and eat it over rice. Whatever you choose to do, you're gonna love it. No wonder this place, lying out the door. What a fantastic meat-filled day I had. Number one barbecue in Texas, then some awesome ramen and steak on a hot stone. That's why I love Texas. And as always, all the places I went to, listed down below for you guys. Thank you all so much for watching. Until we eat again, see you later.